Online shopping is massive. By 2021, it's estimated the global market for online shopping could be $4.8 trillion.
But the problem with distance selling is how easy it is for people to return their items. And if you do, it comes to a centre like this to be reprocessed, costing the retailer money.
This is the distribution and return centre for Wiggle, Europe's leading cycle and accessory retailer. They send thousands of different products around the world each day.
Typically, we process between 30,000 and 40,000 items of stock through this facility each day. So that's going to equate to somewhere in the region of 10 million items of stock that leave here every year. From a returns point of view, it's somewhere around 14,000 units of stock a week that are returned back through the facility. So again, around 700,000 items of stock get returned for various reasons.
And that's pretty standard for lifestyle products. Fashion and sportswear can be as high as 20 to 30%, but cosmetics and fragrance as little as 2% get returned. Sometimes it can be the wrong size clothing, or a customer just buys multiple sizes and returns the ones that don't fit. Sometimes it's a faulty product or just the wrong product, and sometimes the customer can be naughty.
We see that a very small segment of shoppers actually exhibit fraudulent behaviour such as wardrobing. Serial returners, on the other hand, can actually be your most profitable customers. So we see that 20% of shoppers drive 80% of returns. And the key really is to understand what is going on in the world of returns, seeing it as an opportunity to sell more to those individual shoppers, understanding the consumer psychology behind what makes that shopper tick and what their preferred return method might be, so that you can offer the best possible returns policy and then encourage people to buy in the first place.
Nobody would really like the items to be returned, but I think it's part and parcel of being a distance seller, and you have to make that part of the process very painless for your customer to build that repeat trust and that repeat customer basis. So from that point of view, it's a good thing. Obviously from our point of view, it's very often stock that is tied up within a system, and we need to get it back into the pick phases as fast as possible so that we can turn it back into another sale. So the returns process is quite a significant process for the business.
Returns is often seen as a massive problem in the industry, but what we actually believe is now returns is the new battleground for opportunity within retail, especially in the fashion sector. Marketers are really missing an opportunity to sell more internationally. So returns is typically seen as something which is simply a logistics problem, but where the real opportunity is to forget about focusing on the conversion for just a minute and look at the real potential to optimize the post-purchase experience for shoppers by offering a really seamless experience that then encourages them to return again and actually buy more with your brand. So brand loyalty is actually a real asset for returns, whereas previously people just saw it as such a problem.
So a high return rate isn't necessarily a bad thing. In some cases, it simply reflects how generous a company's return policy is. And that's when marketers need to embrace the data, because the value of returns is so huge.
The returns cost the UK market around 8.8 billion. And going on behind that vast scale is things like the original cost of delivery. You've then got the cost of the shopper sending that item back in the first mile alone. Consolidation locally when we're looking at an international return, and then the whole line haul back to the retailer. So there's a lot of operational handling costs, but there's also the cost of the missed opportunity and the time delay that it will take retailers to get that item back in stock and then be able to resell the item. So having really efficient returns processing is super important for retailers to be able to get it back on the shelves and get that item sold again.
And marketers can be their own worst enemies when it comes to returns.
Because we're so obsessed with the conversion and encouraging shoppers to add more to their basket, that actually that could be driving negative returns behaviour. Because if you as a shopper are browsing something, there's a flash sale, there's a countdown telling you you need to add something to that basket now or miss that discount, that means that you're going to panic buy and it can lead to buyer's remorse. Similarly, what a lot of retailers do is to offer free returns based on a certain basket threshold. So again, they'll be encouraging shoppers to add another item to the basket to qualify for that free shipping, which means that that item that they added at the last minute is a guaranteed to come back because that shopper only added the item to get the free shipping in the first place. They bought the item with the intention to return.
So what's the best way for online retailers to handle those high returners?
So my advice to retailers would be to not fear returns and actually see that people who return a lot from you are buying a lot from you. And it costs about the same to return 8 items as it does for 1. So the shopper who's keeping 5 of those items is far more profitable than the shopper who buys a single item and returns a single item.
Hi, I'm James Wright, and thanks for watching Marketing Media Money. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thanks for watching.